We should change that song to makeup bags. makeup bags.
Lip gloss.
Oh my God! You should see this stuff all laid out in here. She came prepared.
Crazy. Oh,
thank you.
Shout out to Kelly Wilson in the building.
Oh, thank
CEO
you.
CEO of Face Dean Custom Lip Colors.
Yes, yes. I have 44 shades.
Nice.
I know I'm having a good time. That's why I'm quiet over here.
Yeah, it's playtime now. Like,
listen, girls. You know, I'm gonna take a picture right now so you can see the colors and all the different shaded things like that. We're just having a ball, and I got the brushes and everything.
They having a spa day in here. Like, me and Jiwoo out of this place.
Yeah, like we just over here. Like, where's the basketball
like,
game?
You know how it be when girls link up, makeup.
You got a lot of.
So we're gonna play over here. You guys can
y'all
talk
need
about
to have a sleepover party.
LeBron and.
So tell us a little bit about Face Fiend.
Okay, well, Face Fiend was something that came about maybe about 4 months ago. I've always been interested in makeup ever since I was in high school. I've been doing makeup since. So I've always gotten compliments about, well, who does your lipstick? What kind of lipstick is that? And it's just lipsticks that I was throwing together, mixing a little of this and a little of that. So then I end up finding a formula, tweaked it, and seen what really worked for me. Tried different things out. It's all organic and gluten-free. It has things like castor seed oil, sunflower, cocoa, just to name a few, olive fruit. So it's a good moisturizer for your lips. With the tints that I do have, it is like a lip stain. So even with eating, drinking, stuff mm-hmm. like that, it still has the color.
So you mean to tell me, like, if my woman is wearing something, mm-hmm. wearing someone's lipstick, she's not
exactly what woman? Who that? I want to know, you know, what woman you
tracing
about?
The lipstick? That's what you asked me? And are we going to be tracing a face paint? Well, yes. You know, it's a little, it leaves a stain somewhat on your lips.
Ooh.
On your lips.
The collar?
Because
you can't get away with
collar, cheek, lips, you know, whatever works for you. You know, whatever you and your girl
you
want
no lipstick stains on the collar. That's how you get in trouble.
Yes.
So she got to hug up. She got to hug up, not
right.
down.
What's your most popular color that you got going on?
My most
so
popular
you got, like, you
colors.
Said 44 colors, right?
44 shades.
Now, you have to have the most, like, everybody goes, the go-to color.
I have something that is called, it's a pink nude, and it's actually called PYT.
Pretty Young Thing?
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow. That's a good name.
And this is what we have right here. And it's almost, it's a nude light pink sheer tint. Mm. And most women, when it comes to lipsticks, they're kind of, you know, not too sure if they want to travel out the box with a lot of colors. So they stick to what they're used to. Mm. And that's normally reds, golds, browns. Black is making a big comeback. Burgundy.
Black.
They're really into lipstick. It with this whole, yeah.
Would you be interested in trying something like that?
Oh, I have it.
Now, my black is actually called Crow. They all have different names. They all have different names.
Oh, so you name them.
Yeah.
Like, kind of like oils.
So this is kind of like oils, absolutely.
Too much to count here. How many colors?
I have 44.
So now, is the line is open and ready to go, purchase and all?
Yes, absolutely. I have my website to be up in about 2 weeks, so look forward to that. Face Fiend Custom Lip Pods by Kelly Wilson. But right now, you can check me out on Instagram, Facebook. I have the colors posted as well as the names. All of my contact information.
She's a marketing animal.
All of my contact. That's what I have learned with doing this. It's about branding and networking and getting out there and be able to talk to people and I stand by my product. I believe in my product. I stand by my product and get your Face Fiend Custom Lip Pods.
now with the prom season coming up. Spike in sales.
I've already seen the spike in sales with prom. Okay. Like prom fight night was a good night. I did all the girls' faces. Girls want to go.
Oh, so you also do makeup?
Oh, I do makeup.
So where's the makeup line, girlfriend? Let's get it together.
One thing at a time. One thing at a time.
No, I know. This
but
is a lot
available
of work.
For makeup as well. Contact me, Face Fiend, Instagram. I'm available for makeup as well. But that's what it started off with, me doing makeup, and then lipstick came along. So now with this being prom season and graduation and just date nights and all that good stuff,
so you're busy.
Just being in the city of Chester, I know quite a few people, a few people know me, so they've always, with them just complimenting me on my makeup and lipstick. Right, it just made her more comfortable with, I'm gonna go ahead and try her product and see how I like it. And it has been working out. So Chester, I like
what you got going on right now. Cause right now you're as Pop was saying, coordinate.
Oh, thank you.
You got the blue scarf with the blue lipstick and it's just popping off just right.
Yeah, your hair got a little tinge.
Yeah, I got a little forest green indigo.
I love it. I love the curls. Okay, but back to the lip gloss. So you said they're made of natural products. So what's the difference between, you know, organic lipsticks and the regular lip glosses? You know, what's the difference between
For one being the ingredients that they have. Some, I never knew that some lipsticks actually had cork in them.
What?
A fat base.
I think I heard that.
It's a fat base. And a lot of lipsticks that we wear have a fat base in it. Which I would say is probably needed in some sense. But after I was able to tweak it and figure out how I needed my formula, it just worked out. So I'd probably say that's probably one of the biggest things, and a lot of people don't know that. And so once I started doing the research about it, I was kind of shocked, and it's like,
So no
animal based
products.
There's no animal based products at all.
Wow.
This isn't gonna cause any type of like
breakouts. But I had to learn that through trial and error. I learned that through trial and error. Oh, that looks pretty. And it comes with the brushes. I found that the brushes were better for application, because you can put on, you can brush it on your lips almost like a paint opposed to just putting it on there. And the two brushes that I do have, I have a dual end one. One is a goat hair and the other one is a sponge. And so the sponge is pretty much to clean up, and the goat hair is for easy paint on your lips. How pretty!
Get a shot of that iced out. Check that out.
I say, short hair girl, the lipstick, I love it.
I love it.
Yeah, yeah.
Very pretty.
Hey,
Thank you. Now
you say how long have you been wearing makeup now?
I've been wearing makeup personally for about, give or take, 13 years.
Now, like, I don't know how old you are, but
I'm 30.
Was your mama like, girl, take that makeup off?
No, because you're
not wearing no makeup in here.
I didn't do it all at once.
It started a little bit
at a time, and it started off with just like lip gloss and mascara. At 15, I had great skin, so you didn't, you know, concealer and all that stuff.
So it was a literally natural look.
So then, of course, senior year comes, and my mom wasn't the one. My dad was the one.
Daddy was the one like, okay.
So, well, you want to change your hair? You got the lipstick on. But in high school, it's really just about finding yourself, your own identity, what you kind of look I was going for. So I pretty much kind of look like this in high school.
That's what's up, man. Now, how many colors did you say all together?
I have 44 so far. 44. So far.
How many more shades can you come up with?
Well, you never know. It's different with everyone, because if I have if it's a shade that a person needs that I don't have, bring a shoe, bring a pocketbook, bring an earring.
We're gonna make it together.
We're gonna make this and we're gonna figure this out.
I like the large variety because, like you said, I mean, everybody's different. You know, you want to cater to everybody.
Because then when it comes to lipstick, it is 1,000 different brands of lipstick out there.
Let me see one of those.
What's your favorite? That's my mom's BMW. That's named after my mom. That's BMW style right there. Which one? Hers is an orange. It's like a spicy orange color.
Now, what do you have, like a chemical lab or something to make this stuff together? what do you put this thing in?
Now, if I tell you, I have to kill you. I just have a small space at home.
Nothing wrong with that. It's my private area. You've been doing this for four months.
Absolutely. So, you know, I just get in there, mix it up, see what I come out with. If it's something I like, it's a keeper. If it's something I don't like, probably still a keeper, because if I don't like it, somebody else may like it. So that's how I come up with all these different colors. So just trial and error, pretty much.
You know, it's crazy because I was doing a promo for this, and I was trying to do a little promo and pick out the lips, and I asked somebody, you know, which one should I put on the promo?
Uh-huh.
And they were like,
Yo, he's got, this is nice, man.
And they went and Googled your name and you know, try to get your information and all this and that. You know, they really are feeling the color right now that you got going on.
I said, well, I like that color that you had, the lips that you picked. I said, oh, that was a good color he picked. That was peaches and cream.
That.
Somebody else picked that.
Yeah,
that was peaches and cream.
Shout out to Karen.
Thank you, Karen. That's one of my favorite colors.
Now, you said that you know, you're one man band, right? What do you think about the marketing? I know you're going to need some help with that as far as getting you to a broader audience. You know, just not Chester. You want to go region,
Hollywood.
Worldwide.
Absolutely.
So you're going to have to branch out somehow. Mm-hmm. You know, you have any ideas of getting the team together to take this to the next level, maybe?
Well, I don't have a team together thus far. I do have a person that I'm working with who is helping me getting my website up. But as far as like a mentor, mm-hmm. I really don't have a mentor. Mm-hmm. It's just pretty much just reading about starting your own business, how to brand yourself, where I just went and got books. I mean, of course, I know I'm going to have to talk with someone to really give me the odds and ends on how to really branch it off and really make it be a really profitable thing for me. So it's going to come. It's going to come. Mm-hmm. I'm not exactly sure what direction to go yet, but every day I'm learning something new, and every day I'm more confident about it, and so I'm halfway there.
I say you're there. I say you're off to a good start. It's just just a matter of time, and I mean a matter of a short time, girl. I'm loving
I'm quiet over here. I'm liking the color.
I'm gonna take off the black because, you know, I wanna try the red. Let me see. Oh look, this matches my shirt.
That's Future Punch. That is Future Punch.
Now let me ask you this. There are a lot of, you know, people coming out with different lines, makeup lines, perfume lines. Is there anybody out there that inspires you? Any artist out there or any makeup designer?
Not anybody in particular. If I have to say who I look up to as far as businesswoman and I'm liking how she's making moves, that would be Keisha Dior.
Keisha Dior?
I'm loving. I like the moves that she makes and pretty much, and just really how she's networking herself. But she already kind of had a platform coming in as, you know, a video girl and then switching over and doing the lipstick. So she's somebody that I look up to. And just anybody that's really doing it. Y'all out there doing y'all thing. It gives me that everyday push like, I can do this. Right. I can do it. This is going to work. Facing, here we go.
Right.
Now, as far as, like, we talked about marketing now, as far as that, who do you think this is going to cater to more? What audience are you trying to reach? Look at everybody.
Just a little bit of everybody. Just women in general. Because I can't say that it's for the younger crowd.
You can't limit it to women.
Exactly. My queens, who's ever into lipstick.
Whoever
is into lipstick, I cater to all. So it really doesn't matter how young, how old, what gender. Really doesn't matter. It's all in what you like.
Okay.
It's all in what you like. So I cater to everyone. Because, you know, it's, you know, older women sometimes are not into a lot of clothes. But then you have a lot of older women who will throw on a blue like they were 16.
Right.
So, yes. Like they're 16. So it's really all comes down to what they like.
I would definitely throw some of that BMW on my lady.
Yeah, you like the BMW.
Which one of them?
Is it many BMWs?
No, lady.
Oh, man, hey, don't put me out there like that. No.
Hey, let's not talk about G. Woo. Let's get back to Poindexter.
Exactly. Don't go back to Poindexter.
No.
She's straightened up real quick.
This is Mrs. Wilson.
Let's bring her back.
But you know what? I do like, you know, the lip gloss. I've always been, please don't take this away, but I've always been a fan of lip gloss. You know,
okay.
Because I always felt like, you know, I like
to be putting lip gloss on.
No, I don't.
Exactly.
Because I'm a man. I like women with accessories because it's a feminine thing.
Absolutely.
And you know, to me, lip gloss is like rims on a car. You
yes,
know,
it is.
You have to have
a little shine to it.
A little shine.
Little shine.
Now you can change your lip color like 5 times now. You can like, come
why
in.
Why not? That's what it's here for.
That's
sure.
What's up.
That looks beautiful on you.
Yeah, that looks. Yeah, looks nice right there.
Yeah, baby.
Well, that's what's up, man. I really, really appreciate you coming out and sharing your line with us.
I appreciate you having me. I do.
Do we have any type of, are you going to be anywhere set up as a vendor? Any place?
Now, I don't have a vendor. I don't have a vendoring set up, but you can contact me at 610-872. Get it right.
You can't reach me.
Business number.
Business number.
You can reach me at 610-803-7515. You can reach me on Instagram at Marlene Kelly, or you can check me out on Facebook at Kelly Wilson. All my information and contact is on there. So I'm looking forward to seeing you.
Good luck with everything. You're such a sweet
thank person. You. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Kelly spelled differently, so make sure you put that up.
K-E-L-L-I-E. Kelly Wilson.
You going to hang around a little bit?
Absolutely.
Try some more lipstick?
Sir, gorgeous.
I know.
All
right.
Shout out to my man Iced Out. You got all this, man, because this is beautiful. This is history right now. My man Iced Out's in the building, No Doubt Entertainment. Yo, we'll be right back.